Very good morning. I'm Shilpa. Welcome you all to the NCERT live phone-in program. Exam. When we hear this word, we all feel petrified. We all have hated it at some point in our life. But to make you a confident being, to face this challenge, to take up this challenge, we have kept our today's topic of discussion as face-to-face with the English exam. And to help you, in the studio we have Dr. R. Meganathan, who is an associate professor at Department of Education and Languages in NCERT. And along with him, to represent the student coterie, we have Ms. Yukta Bist, who is a class 12th student at Kendra Vidyalaya, JNU campus. I welcome both of you on today's show.
Thank you.
So let's proceed to understand our today's topic of discussion. But yes, before we proceed, I would like to convey one information to my audience is that we have started a very special program, which is guidance for students exam time. We have considered the exam time very carefully, and we have done a research about it, and that's why we are so willing to take up your query, your suggestion, your feedback concerning this, for which you can call on our toll-free number, which is 1-800-111-265, and another number which you can see on our YouTube channel NCERT official, and also you can send your query on ciet.kishoremunch@gmail.com. So the first thing we have kept our today's topic of discussion is face to face with the English exam.
Yeah.
Why did you thought of this topic?
Okay, fine. Actually, you know, these are exam times. Mm-hmm. Almost every parent, every child who were in classes 10th or 12th, they are actually in some tension or other. Some sort of pressure on children, and so is on parents. So let us take up this issue and answer some of the queries which children face before taking up examination.
Right.
But we are not counseling them the anxiety of examination. We are now taking up how to attempt questions in English examination, particularly class 12. We have a student from class 12,
right.
So that's the idea. One is overall understanding. I have been studying last 1 year the prescribed syllabus and various components of examination as a student. So it has reading, writing, then literature based questions, that is from textbook. We have the textbooks, to class 12 textbooks, and the long reading, all the things. So how they can plan very well at the last moment so that they can boost up their percentage, of course, one, and without any stress or trauma taking up the examination.
Right.
So that's the idea. So let us have a discussion with the
so
student.
I'll just leave this table for you to bombard questions on Dr. Meganathan.
Thank you so much, ma'am. So today I'm here to just clear my doubts and some of my friends' doubts from Professor Meganathan. And also I have been suffering from that trauma that our examination is on 2nd March, and we all have been facing some problems, some questions to ask. So this is like the best opportunity for me also.
Okay, fine. You go ahead. Before you go ahead, you don't take it as a trauma. You have been studying for last almost 11 months. So this is the kind of last leg of your race, in a way race, though we shouldn't be calling it. And moreover, Central Board of Secondary Education, CBSE, has kept English or Hindi as the first exam, I think.
Yeah.
So it's kind of, when you compare English with the other subjects, languages with the other subjects, they are slightly less stressing, so less loaded. So that's one reason. So you can take up the exam enthusiastically, joyfully, and write. And secure very good percentage marks. That also matters. So now,
do you have any doubt?
Yeah, I have some doubts. Like from this beginning, I want to start with that. What should be the way to start the question paper? Like which section should we do first?
Okay, fine. Okay, Yukta. So it is up to you. We have, if you look at the slide there, we have three sections in our board exam. One is the reading, you can see it, then advanced writing skills, then literature based questions, some for textbooks, and that, as you can see that on the slide. Reading you have 30 marks, advanced writing skill for 30 marks, then literature based questions 40 marks. So I would suggest, I just spoke to some of the teachers, and as a teacher also I feel that whatever you are comfortable with, So, you can choose. But I have some personal recommendation that you may attempt the 40 mark literature reader first, because you know most of the things as the back of your hand.
Yes.
All the lessons you have read and the question answers also you must have come across one way or other. That is one thing. And you can take up writing second and reading last, because reading might take some time. You may have to read and reread. We will come
yes.
to that. That is one thing. But I leave it to any child. I am comfortable with the reading. With one reading, I can answer all the questions. We will come to how to attempt reading part, we will discuss that, but it is up to you. But I recommend, let us do literature first, but one thing is, whichever part you take, you write the question numbers carefully well, so that the examiner identifies.
Yes.
Fine.
Sir.
Right.
Even
okay.
I have a doubt, Dr. Meganathan. What sometimes children do, they take one question from the reading section, they take one question from the writing section. And sometimes like
and make it a mess.
Yeah. she used
does
the right
that,
word.
Affect
no,
mind?
No. But as an examiner, we teachers know that a child can take any question anywhere and answer. But only way to not to confuse the examiner is number the questions carefully well in little bigger than the other things you are writing. But it would be fine that you take one section and all the questions, whatever questions you know, answer them, then move on to next one.
So, that's a myth that people do say that if you will do your exam in sequence, you will get the more marks.
No, it's not that. It's a myth. It's a myth. But the teachers and the examiners are more compassionate. Whatever benefit, that will go to the child. But we don't bother whether this question from this section, reading section has been answered first, this one. But as far as possible, if you know, take up one session. Whatever questions you know, you answer them first, then move on to next section.
Okay.
So that complications are reduced. That's fine. Yeah.
Okay,
then,
sir.
Now. Yeah. Go ahead.
Okay, sir. So as a student, the most difficulty I feel in is in the reading section, because there are many unseen passages which take a lot of time and they are very time consuming. So what is your advice for them?
Okay, fine. Yeah, the practice it's rather than advice. So whatever way, I have got the question paper with me. Let us see. I have got the question paper with me. Then you go to the slide. So you will find a reading passage. I would suggest don't read the reading comprehension questions first. Read the passage once. Your first reading, just read the passage. Then you go to the questions. Read the second time. Because I don't think English language examination time is a constraint. You will be able to complete comfortably well in time. Some children I have seen that 15 minutes, 20 minutes before they do it. So the first reading, read the text carefully without going into the question. Then read the question, come back, specific questions you try the answer. So that's one. But most children what they do, many children what they do is, they first read the question and look for the answers. But first reading should be a comprehensive reading just to understand. You don't have any questions in mind, just the story you are following. Then go to the question. That's what I said.
So you are saying that when we get 15 minutes before the exam for reading, we should read the passages first.
Yes. And of course, that 15 minutes are given to you just to understand the whole question paper, but you read the reading passages within the 15 minutes. It's possible, because you have two reading passages. One is for comprehension questions and vocabulary. The other one is for note making. Fine. You can reread. I would not hesitate to suggest if you read three times, no problem, no issue.
Okay,
but you will have still time to that.
Okay, sir.
But
thank
I would
sir.
Like to invade in between the conversation.
Please.
The point is that the school teachers, even when I was in school, my English teacher used to say that read the passage questions first, so that you will get the gasp of it, what exactly is it, and so that you can just simultaneously find out the answer.
Yeah, fine. Maybe that may be a strategy. Let's not blame the teacher. The idea is I need to understand the passage. This is the reading passage I have. I need to understand it. So how will I understand? Then when I read the question and come back, I would be able to locate it better. Rather than when I read the questions and come back to first read the question and come to read the passage. So my intention will be looking for answers to each question. Now already you have 7-8 questions. So which question you will be focusing? So the ideal way is read the passage first, then go to the questions.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
Fine. Yeah.
Okay, sir. Mm. So another question that you have, I think, already said the answer, but again, I want to ask how to complete English exam in a way that 15 minutes could be left for revising.
Okay, fine. See, one is you should be alert. That you are very conscious of you are in an examination hall. It is not to say that you should be in tension or that you be alert. That's quite natural because you are writing an exam. So keep checking your time and whichever section you write fully. For example, we will come to discuss how to do writing. Suppose don't spend too much time on a particular question more than required. For example, you are writing an article. We'll discuss that sometime you spend to make the points and start writing. Then when you start writing, you can say, I can spend 20 minutes on this or whatever time. So then it exits, then you be a little faster. But of course, don't bother about very beautiful handwriting. Your handwriting has to be legible. So many children feel that if I have to be very beautiful, no, you should be neat and clean. When I read your handwriting, any examiner, it should be readable. That's what we call it intelligible, neat and clean. That's what. Yes.
Right.
Yeah. Then, so you arrange, and definitely you will have 15 minutes because now you are getting 15 minutes extra beforehand. Then most children in English and Hindi languages examinations, they complete well in time.
Okay.
That's fine. So I don't.
I really like this tip that we can actually utilize that 15 minutes we have given.
Extra.
We can actually use it.
Yes.
Fine. So, go ahead.
Okay, sir. So, another, this question was suggested by my friends and also I face this problem that some students are not grammatically strong or do not have a very good vocabulary base. So, what hacks would you give them to prepare in very short time?
Okay. One is the key to the reading part says that you are expected to answer the question in one sentence, sometimes even one word or two, three words. So, there in reading comprehension passage questions, it is not expected all children to be writing completely grammatically right. If there are errors also, that the expected answer is there, it's given full mark. So, I would suggest that these children take up reading very well and do it. And also, check before you are writing, talk to yourself and see that whether my sentences are right. And if some such cases, if there are mistakes, that we will have to really rectify
some it. Students also try to convert Hindi. First, they feel it in Hindi and then they
that
try
to matter. That means most of us, that doesn't matter. Most of us non-native English speakers, we assume that we think in our languages and do it. It's a quite natural sociolinguistic, psycholinguistic phenomenon. It's quite natural for me. It doesn't matter.
Right.
But let them think, I may think in Hindi or in my language Tamil and write in English. Doesn't matter. But you have to write coherently without mistake, without errors. That's why.
So, related to this, we had got a question from Mr. Mohit. And he was saying, English exam is like an FELTIS for me. As I am not an English fluent person. So, what kind of tips you would like to give?
Could you please repeat the question?
The question is that it's kind of nightmare for him, the English exam, because he's not that English fluent.
No, doesn't matter. He is also a student?
Yeah.
Okay, fine. No. See, we need not worry about examination. I think the least number of failures nowadays is in languages. Not many children fail. And the question paper has been set in such a way that getting 35 to 50, 45 is easier. That's why that reading comprehension and writing comes to almost 60 marks, if I am right, 60 marks. So, if you attempt all questions, you are bound to pass. No, you can't fail this examination. So, then where is the question of trauma?
Right.
I don't think. And you must have been a regular student preparing yourself. Reading, I would say that read all the lessons of the textbook before an examination once. You will get your answers because most questions are more than 30% questions are just if you have read the chapters, you can really answer those kinds of things. Then reading, writing, any child in any school would have done some practice. So I think most of them are same pattern. It is like, you know, we will come to that. If you have time, we will discuss that. It must be article writing, letter writing. All children must have practiced. at least 10-15 times. So, some of the questions may be the same idea being repeated. So, there is no question of drama as far as language question examination is concerned. So, I can confidently say that there's a student also would feel that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, sir.
Sir, also before we proceed, most of the students had doubt that concerning should we read the textbook or we should rote learn the questions
and rote learn. See, we are from NCERT. Any good teacher would say that there is no meaning in rote learning because if the question is asked a little differently, you will not be able to answer.
Right.
And if you write the same kind of answer, you will not be getting the desired number, the mark. So better read the textbook, understand and answer to the question. The same question can be asked differently. That's what. And most I don't think CBSE question papers repeat the questions. The same kind of questions don't appear at least for 5 years. So, but the ideas may be the same. For example, writing an article, writing letters, or drafting notice, everything. But ideas are different. Questions are different. Yeah, please.
Right.
Yeah.
So, Yukta, you can just go
on. I want to just interrupt in this discussion that some students try to wrote up the notices and letters also. So, what would you say to them?
Yeah, fine. See, notice writing, letter writing, you get business letters, you get letters to the editor and notices for public notice or school notice board or society in general. So, the format, whatever format taught by the teacher or prescribed, and any format would do. You follow the format, but the event is different. So, they have to really change it. And it is expected that 80 to 100 words have to be written. Then the place of the event, time of the event, and what is the event has to be mentioned. So, there is nothing to just to memorize it, but remember, meaningfully understand, then answer to the question. My question, I'm saying it and again, answer to the question. Suppose you have done in your classroom writing a notice to the school notice board about this sports event, but the question may be write a notice board to the community hall in your village or town about the blood donation camp. You have to really change it. So there is no question of anything to be memorized, but you remember, understand and remember.
Yes.
So the language actually demands understand, comprehend, then write.
Right. Okay. So here we have got a question from a YouTube live stream. Divya. Miss Divya wants to understand, can you please tell the format of invitation?
Okay, invitation. Yeah, I don't know how to do that. Okay, because this is a writing. Fine. Let me write it. Invitation here. We have this one provision to write. So, can we do that here? This one, I am writing it. Invitation, there will be a heading. Invitation, no?
Yes.
So, invitation, there are two kinds of invitation. One is the formal one, another one is the informal one. So, we will take up a kind of, well, if you are inviting your friends and other relatives for your birthday. So, you may have that, you may have in the letter form or just invitation, then looking forward to meeting you when I celebrate my birthday on such and such date. So, what we are expecting is there is no concrete set format. We are expecting the event to be there and day, date and time. Then the invitee. So, I am inviting. Let us say Yukta is inviting for her birthday. That is what. And place and date. Of the date of invitation. This is the event. This we are looking forward kind of format. And format carries in all the questions only one mark. And don't bother much about format. Any format will be accepted. And little bit of mistakes are not completely followed. You may be penalized at the most one mark. We don't do that. At the most half a mark. So, invitation format, but follow. In letter writing, if you do a format, follow, if you follow the recent one, modern format, everything you write in left without punctuation marks, follow, if you take up one format, follow it seriously till the end.
Right.
Don't mix the old format and the new format. Am I right?
Yes,
yeah,
sir.
Fine.
Okay, so if there is an option between notice and invitation, which would be the one to prefer?
And you that the child you have to decide. Notice and between notice and invitation, both have some technicalities, right? The way we discussed, there will be a heading, date, time, and all the invitation as well as notice. You should give the event, date, time, and you are requesting people, what people are expected. Mm-hmm. For example, it's a notice for let us say I said blood donation camp or a sports meet in the school or speech yes. competition. It should have that the school is organized, school sports club is organizing sports event for classes 9 and 10. All those who are interested in are requested to give their names to the sports teacher by this date, and what will be the other conditions, and that's what the timing. Then sports secretary or president sports club, then date and time. So I don't think anything, whichever you feel that you are convinced, you do that. Yeah.
Okay,
examination is for the examinee, not for us, the one who sets the question paper. Yeah.
Okay.
So we just talked about the format in a way. So we have got a question as a part of our question with selfie segment. So it's a question. I would request my team to play the video.
Well, I'm from KVJMU. My question is that I face some difficulties to the format of article and report, and I would like you to please clear my doubt. Thank you.
So it was the question from Miss Megha, and she basically faces a problem in article and report writing. So what do you suggest? Yeah.
Okay. Article and report writing. See, article you write on a theme, you discuss the theme, pros and cons of it, and analyze it, then try to suggest a solution. For example, let us take the common thing of pollution today. During winter it increases, people face problem, eye burning, lot of things. So the question is, supposing write an article to a newspaper about the problem of pollution during winter, the increase of pollution. So I am expected to give a title. Title may be given later, start of later, but I, as a writer, I love to jot down points. If you go there, how to write long answer questions, go down. Answer the long answer questions like article writing or report writing. Spend 5 minutes and jot down the points, then make an outline and come to conclusion which will come first, which will come next. I would suggest write maximum of 3 to 4 paragraphs, am I right?
Yes.
Yeah, then 3 to 4 paragraphs and start writing. Have at least 4 to 5 major points with their conclusion. And write any good writing, any newspaper report, there will be some introduction which takes the reader into the problem. For example, nowadays major cities and all over the country, winter, the pollution increases during the winter. The reasons are many. So you are taking the reader into that. Then write reason 1, reason 2, reason 3. Then say that what could be the solution. Same way, report writing, you are reporting an event or an accident, some happening. So that report should have in the beginning 5 people have been injured in an accident. So it's kind of newspaper reporting. Otherwise, the school celebrated school annual day on such and state. So you begin with the event, then describe the events, and report writing may have three paragraphs as per the requirement of the number of words, then conclude what was, how many people participated, what people speak. So there is no, but divide your ideas into minimum 3 to 4 paragraphs and give an attractive title.
Oh, wonderful tip, sir.
Thank you, sir.
That was the student was asking. Yeah, fine. Yeah.
Yes, sir. So I want to change the topic. That as you know that some students don't give much attention to the English subject or the language subjects, and they try to muggle up everything at the last moment. So and it may affect to their minds or something. So you want
fine.
To
suggest
something?
In the afternoon, Shilpa has pointed out, announced also in the afternoon 4 to 5 we have a discussion on that. See, we generally say failure to plan is planning to fail. as a student, I must plan. So I have one whole year in the beginning. Now I have only 1 week or two weeks. How will I organize? Shilpa recommended, I also recommend that read the textbook lessons once more again.
Okay.
Then take up the question paper which is with us. Then see where I have to concentrate. I should do some reading practice, reading comprehension practice.
Yeah.
I should do some writing practice. Then I have the textbook with me. I plan myself. Then write. So there is a need to plan every day on day wise, at least from now onwards. And I know that why children get muddled up is my physics takes me a lot of time, my chemistry takes me a lot of time, that the demanding subjects. We have to in between. I generally, personally, I will suggest that you have some casual time to read for the languages. You read the serious things, physics, chemistry and all. I am an English teacher, I shouldn't be saying it, but still I am saying. Why? Because for post lunch, you read sometime English language. Every day you do something. Every day, every subject you must be doing.
Mm-hmm.
This is a kind of general suggestion. But don't give up anything. You should have the knowledge of the whole, all the lessons of textbook and the long reading, then the reading writing.
Okay, sir.
So before we proceed, sir, we have got a very cute viewer asking a question. So I would request to play the video.
I am in second class. My exam of English in this month. I learn and try to memorize sentences. So in exam, I forget even and I forget the whole sentence. What should I do?
So I'll just repeat the question, sir. So the question is, I am Chandramani Tiwari, I am in second class, my exam of English is this month, so I learn and try to memorize sentences. So even that children forgets an even an A, so he just forgets the whole sentence. So what he should do?
He is actually reflecting the what to say, I don't want to use the word, the pathetic way of Indian education system itself. We rely more on memorization,
right.
That is not actually ideal for language, learning the language. The child should be able to construct his own sentences. If he is given an opportunity during the classroom teaching and at home, can you make 5 different sentences of the same event? The same thing, he has to write, you know, I am so and so, my name is Mohita, something, no? Then I am in class 2, he is from class 2. It's really bad to see that a class 2 child is stressed and traumatized,
right.
Because he is forgetting whatever he has memorized. So if he is traumatized or stressed in some other way, that someone is troubling me, then we can rectify it. The whole process of teaching, learning, and the child is made to believe that unless otherwise you memorize, you cannot write. No, what the child is should be said, you can construct your own sentences and think in the way she pointed out, think in your own language, and how you write in, you say it in your language, then you say it in English. There is nothing wrong. But you can also directly ask the child that you know that you are speaking in English. He was speaking in English
and
in his own way and very nice, cute.
Yeah.
So I don't think it will be a problem. Through practice, we should do away with the memorization, rote memorization. Memorization may have some value, but rote memorization does not have any value at all. So let me do with understanding. Language or any learning is with understanding. We say the language is making meaning. How that meaning happens is when I understand and write. I can say it, my name is Meganathan. And I should also be made to make a statement, Meganathan is my name. So how various ways and means, this should have happened in the classroom. So I think the child should be supported, the teachers and the parents who might be listening to this should actually take care that the child reads more and interacts more so that the language gets formulated, developed in him.
So we have kind of come to the end of our show. So your few words to encourage our students, teacher,
okay.
And also parents.
Okay, Yukta is there, including Yukta. All children don't have to bother. Examination is part of our schooling system, university system. It's part of learning, teaching. It is not going to make any great difference that I got 70% or 90%, and you are going to go to have a good future. And plan properly, meticulously, and spend time to read the reading comprehension passages. For writing, spend some time to jot down the ideas, plan, then write. So you are a great human being, you have a great thing called your brain. Use your brain. Many people would be advising, but learning, you have learned the whole year's hard work will be useful for you. You will be doing well, and we wish every child, every learner in classes 10 and 12 all the best and come out with flying colors.
So, Yukta, you also would like to wish your colleagues or your same
friends.
Kind?
Definitely. Thank you so much, sir, for your kind advices. And it was very important for ourselves to boost up. And you did that for us. And thank you so much for
thank
that.
Thank you. Thank you.
So, I hope after watching our today's episode, you will be able to face the English exam with much of confidence. So, thank you both of you for being a part of our today's show.
Thank you very much.
Still, you have any question or the query related to our today's episode, then you can dial into our toll-free number or can drop an email to us or can contact us via through our social media websites. Till then, take care and keep watching Kishore Munch.